Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Marcia Sumo and this is On Review, a channel where we figure out ways to live a beautiful life in Liberia. If it's your first time here, I urge you to hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification button so you don't miss our videos every Friday. Since my last video, I've been getting tons and tons of questions on how to start a smart home, what do I need to start a smart home, and a lot of other questions. And I will address those questions in subsequent videos, but today we are going to talk about things you need to know before you start a smart home. First, let's talk about what is a smart home. A smart home has a lot of different definitions, but we can all agree that a smart home is a convenient home setup where you can use your phone to operate your devices in your home and your appliances. I just want to let you know that you can start a smart home at any time and at any stage. If you live in a 1920s house or 1980s house or a 1990 house, you can still upgrade your home to be your smart home. You should also know that a home is as smart as you are. So let's quickly talk about the three things you should consider when starting a smart home. The first is your mindset. You need to know why you want a smart home. When I started, my thought process was clear. I didn't want to live the same way I live in a rented home. And I wanted to make life easier for me by finding ways to save time and money. Those were the things that guided my thoughts on starting a smart home. For example, I had my home keys on my office bench. And being a forgetful person that I am, I always used to leave my home keys at my office. And I would go home and stay at the door and wait for my driver to go get the keys or call Bill to bring his keys and all that. So when it was time to buy my lock, I decided to buy a smart lock. And this smart lock got nothing to do with internet or electricity. It's just a lock that you can use one key to program all your doors, or you can use several keys to program one door. So at that point, I had three keys that worked with every door. If I leave one at the office, I have one in the car. If I forget that one in the car, I have one in my bag. So it was convenient for me to have a smart lock. It solved that problem of being forgetful. And now I don't even need my keys. I stand in front of the door and the door opens automatically for me. So that is a problem that I have solved, which is a second thing to consider. What problems are you trying to solve? There should be a problem or something that you are trying to make functional in your life or in your home that you think that technology can help you with. For me, I had three things in mind. As a lazy person and someone who runs three companies, I don't have time to be a housewife, maybe on Saturdays, but I needed my home to function as if I was there every day cooking and cleaning. I also wanted peace of mind. I wanted security when I'm asleep or away from my home. And like I said before, I wanted options. Options in everything that I do. I believe I'm successful when I have options in situations. Third thing to consider is your situation on electricity and internet. A lot of us don't have 24 hours current. Some people in Liberia do. They have a solar system or 3-4 generators and LEC that work interchangeably to give them 24 hours current. If you are like me who don't have 24 hours current, I suggest you invest in equipment that are both battery operated and use current, that is AC and DC. And for internet, we all know that we have the same problems when it comes to internet. Wi-Fi here, the speed has problems, connectivity up and down, and a lot of other things going on with our internet. I suggest that you invest in maybe Bluetooth devices, Zigbee devices, or Z-Wave devices. You may need the Wi-Fi to set up, but most of these things communicate with each other without Wi-Fi when it comes to Z-Wave, Zigbee, and Bluetooth. So I have had a lot of requests on me doing a house tour. I have made a conscious decision to invite you into my home for education purposes only. So next week we'll be doing a house tour, then we'll jump right back into things you need to start a smart home. Till then, see you next week.